Welcome back, children. I hope all of you are well and safe. Today I will start your third chapter of mathematics. In this chapter, we will learn addition and subtraction of two digits numbers. The name of the chapter is Give and Take. How is then give and take connected with addition and subtraction? I will explain this with the help of an example. Suppose your sister has 10 pencils. Now you have 15 pencils. If you give your sister 2 pencils from you, then your sister will have 12 pencils and you will have 13 pencils. That means your sister will have 2 more pencils and you will have 2 less. So we can say this in this way, that your sister has addition of 2 pencils or and you have reduction or subtraction of 2 pencils. This is the number table of your textbook. This table has 10 rows and 10 columns. So it contains number from 1 to 100. Now we will use this number table to add and subtract numbers. Now let us take the story of Kittu. Kittu has 100 rooms in his home and he wants to paint some of the rooms. Say room number 2 and room number 12. How he can move from 2 to 12? See the table A in the slide. He starts from room number 2. He adds 10 to 2 to reach room number 12 and paint it. To add 10 to 2, we can go all the way to the right to 10. Then up to 11 and one step right to 12. This is one way to go from 2 to 12. And this is shown in the table A with red arrow. There is a shortcut route also, and that I will show the table B in the slide. We can jump up one row from 2 to 12. A jump from 2 to 12 is like taking 10 steps. This is shown in table B with green arrow. I will explain these two examples in the next slide. Now, let us add 14 and 10 with the help of this number table. We can do it in two ways. Number one, start from 14 in the number table and go right to 20, then jump up to 21 and then 4 steps right to 24. This is shown with red arrows in the table. And second way, start from 14 and then jump up one row to 24. One row means 10. So that means 14 plus 10 equal to 24. This is shown with green arrow in the table. Next, how can I go from 22 to 41? One way is start from 22, jump up 2 rows to 42. 2 rows means 20. That means 22 plus 20 equal to 42. Then one step left to 41. That means 42 minus 1 equal to 41. This is shown with red arrows. Second way, start from 22, one step left to 21. That means 22 minus 1 equal to 21. Then jump up 2 rows to 41. 2 rows means 20. That means 21 plus 20 equal to 41. This is shown with green arrows. Find my food. Try these on Kittu's home. Hey, I have something more interesting for you. Ma told me there are sweets to eat in some rooms. Help me find that room. The answers from the next page will help you find that room. Mark them in my home. First, 10 less than 34 is 5th. Second, 53 minus 20. Third, 11 more than 31 is. This all I have done here, but that answer how these are coming, that I will show in the next slide. we will calculate 10 less than 34. Less means subtraction. 10 means one row. Start from 34, move one row down to 24. So the answer is 34 minus 10 equal to 24. That I have done in the previous slide. Calculate 53 minus 20. 20 means two rows. Minus means you have to do subtraction. So start from 53, move two rows down to 33. That means 53 minus 20 equal to 33. That I have done in the previous slide. Here, this is shown with red arrows. Calculate 11 more than 31. More means you have to do addition. You have to add 11 to 31. 11 means one row up and then one step right. Now, this can be done in two ways. First, start from 31, jump up one row to 41, then one step right to 42, shown with red arrows in the table. Second way, start from 31, move one step right to 32, then jump up one row to 42, shown with green arrows with in the table. That is 31 plus 11 equal to 42. That I have done in the previous slide. Do these sums as homework. So use the methods you have learned so far to solve the sums in this slide. Remember, for addition you have to move up and right in the table, and for subtraction you move down and left in the table. D, 11 less than 66. Less means subtraction. Here you have to subtract 11 from 66. 66 minus 11 equal to 55. E, 62 plus 13. You have to add 13 to 62. 62 plus 13 equal to 75. F, 23 less than 89. Less means subtraction. You have to subtract 23 from 89. 89 minus 23 equal to 66. G, 10 and 44 more. More means 10 and 40 more. More means addition. You have to add 10 and 40. 40 plus 10 equal to 50. age. 9 added to 28. You have to add 9 and 28. 28 plus 9 equal to 37. Next, I. The sum of 9 and 44. You have to add 9 and 44. 44 plus 9 equal to 53. J. Reducing 98 by 34 gives. Reducing means subtraction. You have to subtract 34 from 98. 98 minus 34 equal to 64. K. 4 and 37 more is. More means addition. So you have to add 37 and 4. 37 plus 4 equal to 41. L. Take 35 away from 83. We get take away. Take away means subtraction. You have to subtract 35 from 83. 83 minus 35, 48. Keep the number table in mind and solve the addition and subtraction sums below. Do not use pen and pencil. Do it in your mind. First, that is 37 plus 9. How much? 46. You can do it in two ways. Long way is start from 37 and move 9 steps right to 46. The shortcut way is start from 37, jump up one row to 47, move one step left to 46. I explained the first example. Try yourself the remaining. Solve the sums below with the help of number table. I will explain two examples for you. First example, 66 minus 55 equal to 11. Start from 66, move 5 rows down. 5 rows means 50, and then move 5 steps left. So 66 minus 55 equal to 11. So the answer is 11. Second, 36 equal to dash plus 9. So, this blanks you have to find out. To do this, start from 9. Jump up 2 rows to 29. And then move 7 steps right to 36. Now, count how many steps you have moved to reach 36. 2 rows means 20 steps. Then, 7 steps right. So, total 27 steps you have moved. So, the answer is 27. I hope you have understood how to solve the remaining. Follow the method explained and do these sums. Now, I will explain another method to do addition. You will find it easier. Do you remember the expanded form of a number? We will use that method for addition. Question: the Anisha bought apples for 37 rupees. Raja bought bananas for 21 rupees. The woman selling fruits said 37 is 30 and 7, 21 is 20 and 1. So 37 and 21 make 58. I am explaining 37 plus 21. How we break 37 into 30 plus 7 and 21 into 20 plus 1. Now add 30 plus 20 and 7 plus 1. 37 we are expanding it and 30 plus 7 and 21 also we are expanding 20 plus 1. So 30 plus 20 we will add now and 7 plus 1. 30 plus 20 equal to 50 and 7 plus 1 equal to 8. So 50 plus 8 equal to 58. Next, 33 plus 56. Can you do it another way? How? Break 33 into 30 plus 3 and 56 into 50 plus 6. Add. Then what you will do? 30 and 50 you will add. 30 plus 50. Add 30 plus 50 and 3 plus 6. Two digit number you will add and then single digit numbers. So 30 plus 50 equal to 80 and then 3 plus 6 equal to 9. So 80 plus 9 equal to 89. Answer is 89. I have explained it. So now you will do it. Others also you will do like this. The previous two examples of addition with the help of expanded form of numbers have been elaborated in this slide. Follow it minutely. And you have to do the remaining exercise given in your book following exactly these steps. Here, this example is already solved in the same method. Look into it properly so that you can solve the exercise. So this is also expanded form. I have done it for you, but you try to do it yourself and then tally the answer with the slide. This is another example of addition in expanded form. But do you notice the other method the boy in the picture is thinking of? That is, out of the two numbers 56 and 21, he breaks only 21 into 20 plus 1. Then he adds 56 plus 1 equal to 57. And finally adds 57 plus 20 equal to 77. So, you see that when you become familiar with this, when you become more familiar with this method, you need not expand or break both the numbers to add. I'm repeating again. So you see that when you become more familiar with this method, you need not expand or break both the numbers to add. This makes the method shortcut. Here are some exercises. Do it yourself as homework in notebook. Work out the steps in your mind and write the answers directly in the box. I have, of course, written the answers, but use these to tally with your answer. Remember, you will do all homework in notebook. I am repeating, you will do all homework in notebook. Today till this, see you in the next class.